So I just want to play this is some sound. It is a Trump judicial nominee answering a question about whether she believes Brown versus the Board of Education, the Supreme Court ruling that struck down school segregation, was correctly decided.
Do you believe that Brown versus Board of Education was correctly decided?
Senator, I don't mean to be coy, but I think I get into a difficult area when I start commenting on Supreme Court decisions, which are correctly decided and which I may disagree with. Again, my personal political or religious views, I would set aside. That is Supreme Court precedent. It is binding. If I were honored to be confirmed, I would be bound by it, and of course I would uphold it.
Do you believe it was correctly decided?
And again, I will respectfully not comment on what could be my boss's ruling, the Supreme Court. I would be bound by it, and if I start commenting on I agree with this case or don't agree with this case, I think we get into a slippery slope.
Okay, so she was asked at least one more time if Brown versus the Board of Education is one of our country's, if it was correctly decided, it's one of our country's landmark racial equality rulings. How can you be a federal judge and not answer that question, Keith?
You shouldn't. She's, in my judgment, disqualified from serving as a federal judge or on the federal bench because of that answer alone. Brown versus Board of Education was a paramount decision in American legal history. It was decided on May 17, 1954 by unanimous Supreme Court. We're in 2018 now. We have a Trump judicial appointee who doesn't know whether she can say if it was correctly decided or not. The idea is preposterous, but it's consistent with a Donald Trump who can't say whether the people in Charlottesville were right or wrong on either side. It's consistent with John Kelly who thinks that the Civil War was something that could have been resolved if people just compromised more.